We now try to understand the interactions, and then after that, we'll also look at the quadratic effect. So the Hout model had three additional variables, and we have the situation now where there are five variables that are generated from just two originating variables. So eVote is being one, and Bush 2000 is the other one. And so we have also the square term and the two interactions. What we do now, we are looking to visualize what the model thinks these is happening in these five variables. Because the five variables depend on the two original variables, which is one indicator variable and one continuous variable, we can plot this rather nicely. So here's the continuous variable. The indicator variable is the two curves. And here we have the response, the increase in votes from 2000 to 2004 for Bush. Now, what I've done here to plot this, I've code a little later, is I've ignored all the coefficients of all other variables. I'm concentrating on the five variables. I'm also ignoring the intercept. So the scale here does not matter. We're just looking at the shape of the curve. And what we see here is a mild quadratic effect here and a mild quadratic effect here. And the two curves are crossing, which indicates the interaction. So the interaction is definitely there as far as the model is concerned. Okay. So the other thing we see is that for e-voting counties, the red line, there's pretty much nothing happening here. It's a mild curve, but really it's from a linear point of view, if I was doing a straight line, it would be coefficient almost zero. And here I have what looks like a substantial increase. So given that e-vote equals zero for this, I'm going from a substantial increase. So substantial slope to a zero slope. So I'm reducing this, and that corresponds to a negative interaction. I'm going to flip back 5-6 slides to look at the model, see whether that's true. Model, where are you here? So we are looking at the linear effect, right? The linear interaction, not the quadratic one. And in fact, we see we don't know whether it's large, but we see a negative value that's completely consistent with what I just said. It's a drop from a positive slope to roughly a zero slope. Okay, so going back to that graph, here we are. Here is the code, and even if you don't use Stata, I'm just going to briefly talk about what I did here. Here I have the model with e-vote equals zero, and I'm ignoring all the other variables, so the only thing that I'm plotting is Bush 2000 and Bush 2000 squared. And the underscore B is the coefficient for that variable. And here I am setting e-vote equals one, which means I get the coefficient for e-vote as an indicator. And in addition, I get these two interactions here. So yeah, that's how I plotted this. And now we're gonna look at the raw data. The raw data do not adjust for other variables. So to the extent that there are other variables that interfere with interpretation, we might see something that's not exactly the same as we saw in what the model thinks. But maybe we get lucky that we can make out something. So I'm highlighting the 15 counties that are e-voting. And what you can see here, it is gorgeous. It is gorgeous. You see sort of a straight zero line slope here going across red. And then you sort of see, you see the black points, they're increasing, right? So increasing slope. So you pretty much see the exact same picture we had seen before. So if I put them next side by side and ignore the scale because I took out the intercept and everything, here I have a zero slope, more or less, and an increasing slope. A zero slope, more or less, and an increasing slope. I see the exact same picture. G- Given that I see the exact same picture, I can't help but notice these two points. If I think these points are not here, if I ignore them, do I still sleep a slope? Do I still see a slope? I'm gonna say it's completely unclear and probably not, right? The fact that I here have this line with a zero slope hinges on these two observations. If I take these two away, then the red triangles look more or less consistent with the black circles. It all depends on these two troublemakers. Who are these troublemakers? Broward County and Palm Beach County. Those are our the two of the additional high leverage points that showed up when we used the Hout model. And they're also two of the three lowest points for the variable Bush 2000, which is the one here. And so you see one, two, three, these are the lowest, and two of them are here. So they're high leverage because they're very low down here. Oh, well, so we have argued implicitly, well, the problem, or not the problem, the conclusion is all based, hinges on these two observations. So if this is true and the interaction goes away when we take these two out, we can actually test that in the model. So let's go to a model and see whether when we take those two counties out, there's no longer an interaction. Here you see if county is not these one of these two, so I'm taking those two counties out, and I'm also specifying robust regression because we had seen a problem with increasing variance in the diagnostic plot, right? So instead of 67 counties, I now have 65. My R squared is still pretty good. The ANOVA table has disappeared because we are now using robust regression. So we don't really want the ANOVA table here. So what's happening? Oha, the interaction is gone. It's not significant, not even remotely close. And e-voting is not significant. There is no evidence that e-voting contributed to an unusual outcome for Bush. Okay. Well. So. Let's rerun that then with the interactions removed, because if the interactions don't matter and they complicate the model, then I don't actually want them in the model. So I'm now redoing this with the interactions removed, and this model is the same as the original linear model that we showed, except that this model also has the square term in there and those two observations removed. The square term is significant. Highly significant, right? With a negative effect here on the square, but whatever that means. So it's significant. We had already run a linear model with a square term with those two counties included. And we know from that model that the square term was not significant. So the significance of the square term also hinges on only these two observations. Wow, it's all due to these two observations. So, intermediate summary, interaction depends on two observations. Taking it out, there is no evidence that e-voting affected the outcome. Upon removal of the two observations, the quadratic term is now significant. That surprises us. And I will stop here, but in the next segment, we will look at whether this or why this is true. A little bit more closely.